guys, we're going to be checking out Prizm 120 ARGB dual ring fans by Antec, that is for cabinet mounting. I've got 5-in-1 piece with one controller and 5 fans. So let's get into it. So these are the fans that are laid out right in front of you, and they have two headers. One is the 3-pin RGB header that's going to go to your motherboard or your cabinet's own RGB controller, and the other one is the 4-pin power controller that goes into the hub. So the controller has two switches to control the RGB effects and the lighting, and on the left side you've got the power socket, and on the right side you've got 4 RGB socket. Now it's also powered by the SATA cable that comes from your PSU. So let's move on into the cabinet itself. Obviously you need to remove the front panel, and you might have to remove the back panel for cable management purposes and stuff. Now if your motherboard is an MSI motherboard, then you might have something called the Mystic Light that allows you to sync all the RGB components in your motherboard. If yours is an Asus motherboard, then you would have Aura Sync to sync everything. But in my case, I'm not going to be using the motherboard's integrated RGB controller. Rather, I'm going to be going for the cabinet's RGB controller. This is because I need an easier access to switch the lights, and I'm not going to be playing around in the software to change the colors then and there. So this is a quick outlook to show you how the connections are made. I'm going to be connecting all the power headers to the controller, but the RGB headers are going to be going to the RGB controller within the cabinet, like I said before. No matter whichever brand of cabinet fans you go for, the side which has the logo is always the intake, and the side that has the bracket is always the exhaust, and that is the back side of the fan. So I'm going to be installing the fans in the front, the top and the back, so I've opened it up completely so I can have a better workflow. So let's jump into it and see how it's done. If you're looking at this mess, then don't worry, you don't have to mind any cables, because we're just going to be talking about the cabinet fans and its headers. So you'll get one 3-pin header and one 4-pin header. This is the hub controller that came along with the box. So we've connected all the 4 fans power headers to the hub. So this will be providing the power through the SATA cable, and I'll be controlling the RGB through these 3-pin connectors that are connected to the cabinet's own RGB controller. So which means if your cabinet has an RGB strip inbuilt, and it will automatically sync with the fan's colors, which means you don't have to use the inbuilt software, the motherboard headers, for controlling the colors. But that's up to you. I wanted it this way because I wouldn't be changing the colors over and over again, so I'm going on this way. So to quickly wrap it up, this is my setup, 2 at the top, 2 at the front, and 1 at the back. As you can see, these are the exhaust and intake. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button with the bell icon and the like button. I'll see you in the next one.